The RoofBlue solution allows for a combination of green and blue roofing technology to be used in the same space. RoofBlue risers elevate the live roof system and allow for additional stormwater detention below the green roof system. This allows building owners to manage more stormwater on their rooftops, minimizing or possibly eliminating the need for additional ground-level water management tools such as detention ponds and cisterns. How does it work? RoofBlue risers create a gap between the live roof modules and the membrane where water can be temporarily detained using a control flow drain system. During periods of heavy rainfall, peak flow is initially delayed as the green roof plants and soil absorb water. Overflow runoff collects beneath the green roof system, where it moves slowly through a drain with narrow openings that meter the flow of water. Reducing the flow of water provides stormwater management systems with more time to treat runoff, preventing untreated water from entering local waterways. During exceptionally heavy storms, water may overflow above the top of the drain into an opening for faster flow. Most manufacturers will have specific requirements for blue roof applications. In the early stages of design, it is critical for architects and engineers to consult with the preferred membrane manufacturer to ensure the roofing system will be suited for detained water use. Also, confirm that the proposed roofing system complies with local codes. Some municipalities may require secondary, redundant waterproofing membranes or have other provisions for rooftop water detention. Control flow drains and inserts are available from a number of manufacturers. Consult your preferred drain supplier for options, spacing, and sizing recommendations and installation instructions. RoofBlue risers allow for a maximum of 3.5 inches of water detention below the green roof. The risers provide 90% void space for maximum detention of approximately 2 gallons or 7.4 liters per square foot. Designers and contractors must ensure that the water levels never exceed the height of the RoofBlue risers at the lowest point of slope in the vegetated area. If the water levels rise above the height of the risers, the root systems of the green roof plants would be submerged. Prolonged root immersion in standing water can lead to root rot and plant death. Installation of RoofBlue is simple. Risers arrive on a separate pallet from the green roof system. To ensure that live roof module lips meet up, install modules and risers from right to left. One installation team member lays out RoofBlue risers in a row, while another member sets live roof modules atop the risers and pushes them tightly into place. As with all live roof installations, be sure to pull all soil elevators from the previous row as each row is set, and avoid walking on the plants so as to prevent damage. When used in conjunction with a live roof light system, use live roof deep edging at the perimeter. Live roof standard systems atop RoofBlue risers require live roof max edging at the perimeter. For live roof deep and max modules atop RoofBlue risers, there are two options for perimeter treatment. Option one, use live roof standard modules atop RoofBlue risers with max edging for the perimeter rows. Then transition to the deeper soil profile. The module bases for standard, deep, and max systems are the same height and integrate seamlessly without the need for edging. This creates an attractive natural mounding effect. Option two, source or construct a custom perforated, corrosion-resistant edge treatment of sufficient height to contain the soil level above the RoofBlue risers and modules. As an added measure against displacement, LiveRoof recommends that roof edge be fastened to perimeter modules using blind rivets. Every 12 inches, pre-drill holes through the edging and into the plastic module sidewall. Install blind rivets with a hand riveter or pneumatic rivet gun. On wind-challenged applications, designers may choose to use Windisc to connect modules together atop the RoofBlue risers. Using a rubber mallet, tap disc into place after each row of modules and risers are installed. Then, slide the next row of risers and modules into place and push hard to engage the discs fully into the module corner slots. If needed, RoofBlue risers may be custom cut using a chop saw or a reciprocating saw with a long blade. Be sure to choose blades recommended for plastic.